The Liberal Democrats would extend free school meals to all primary school children, said Ed Davey. We're going to read into this exclusive from The Guardian, you guys. Let's go. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world. This is Reganelite here with an exclusive from The Guardian with the headline that the Liberal Democrats would extend free school meals to all primary school children, says Ed Davey. The exclusive reveals that the leader challenges Labour to match his £500 million pledge to be paid with US-inspired shared buyback tax. Guys, while you're here, make sure you hit the like button and share across social media so others are notified of this video. So, this is a very interesting challenge from Ed Davey here. Now, obviously, as a reference, obviously, the London Mayor Sadiq Khan has been very keen to make sure that free school meals are out for those in London as well. As a London Labour mayor, he really does understand the importance of how important it is for school meals to be given to kids. And I do like that the Lib Dems are obviously playing this pool of, yes, giving back and making sure that kids are able to be fed these days. I think it's absolutely disgusting from the Conservatives to try in any way, shape or form not wanting to give any kind of, to try and make it as difficult as possible for kids to get the kind of meals that they want. I just think it's outrageous. And I'm glad that Lib Dems are saying this. I think this is a given. Challenging Labour to match the £500 million pledge does raise questions. Are Labour going to be able to do this? And he obviously says with a US-inspired share buyback tax. So I'm not sure how that would work. Obviously, after we'll read into it in a moment. So does this mean less of the taxpayer forking out for these free school meals is what we're implying from this? Interesting to say the least. I do think Labour will not let kids go hungry. I don't think so. I don't think they're as cruel as the Conservatives, but some people may vehemently disagree with me in the comment section down below. We need to give kids, obviously, in terms of the best future that we possibly can, regardless of whatever their background, whatever area that they are from, whether it's in England, Wales, Scotland, Northern Ireland, doesn't matter. We need to give kids the best futures that they possibly can with what education we can provide them, with making sure that they get the nutrition that they need, the time that they can be given in terms of education. There are lots of things, challenges right now facing our children, especially here in England. It's really, really dire. And this is one step towards making it better for kids. And anything that gives kids a better future, pretty much, and even if it came out at the expense of the taxpayer, I'm all for it, for giving our kids the best possible future and making sure that they are given the meals that they desperately need, because there are some kids in our society that are not getting anywhere near enough food. So the Liberal Democrats would extend free school meals to all primary school children, starting with those in poverty, Ed Davey has said, in a challenge to Labour to match the pledge. Speaking in his first newspaper interview of the general election campaign, the Lib Dem leader announced a manifesto policy aimed at nearly 1 million more children living in poverty in England and their families. The £500 million cost of the pledge would be paid by introducing a 4% share buyback tax modelled on by one brought in by the US President Joe Biden, which the Liberal Democrats estimate would raise £1.4 billion. Okay, interesting. And at present, the government would only provide meals to children in reception, year one and year two, and to children who meet the family income on conditions of 3 years and above. The Child Poverty Action Group estimates that 900,000 children living in poverty and a third of school-aged children in England miss out on free school meals. We think the case for it is overwhelming, Davey said in his interview from the West Country, where his party is targeting a swathe of Conservative-held seats. Liberal Democrats are very progressive politicians. That's who we have always been. It's who we are. We believe in social justice. If we can get some Liberal Democrats MPs in the next parliament, any more of them, these are the things we'll provide for. Davey rounded off his first week on the general election trail on Thursday by caracing down the water slide in Somerset. His approach to campaigning so far has been to engage a series of stunts, including falling off a paddleboard in Windermere and cycling down a steep hill in the Welsh town of Knighton. This kind of stuff, this is... like some of like I know some people see this as a bit, it's a bit silly, and it's like, why is he pulling off these stunts and what's this kind of stuff? It's getting headlines. It's getting people talking about the Liberal Democrats. It's raising their profile. This is what this is. And the problem is that and this was heard about, and I've seen in other live streams and whatnot. You know, the mainstream media are not giving enough coverage to the likes of the Lib Dems and the Green Party, for example. They're giving Reform plenty of coverage. They're giving, obviously, Labour and the Conservatives, because they're the two main parties, obviously plenty of coverage. But the Lib Dems and the Greens, they really have to push really hard to get coverage. Now, I'm not sure what the Greens are going to be doing in terms of pushing for their media coverage, because they need to really step up to the plate and really get more coverage, because I want to cover more of the Green Party as well. Don't get me wrong, I'm gonna cover as much of the political parties here in England as I possibly can, and I want to cover more of the Greens just as much as I want to cover all the other parties. But the Liberal Democrats, what they're doing right now with Ed Davey, with these stunts and all that, it does seem kind of silly, it does seem kind of goofy, but it's getting in the papers, it's getting people talking about them. And it's making media outlets talking about them as well. And I've covered this. I've covered this before. So it's a good thing for them to get this, because they're like, Liberal Democrats. Yeah. But it also may jog a few memories. So it's like, wait a minute, isn't this the same Liberal Democrats that made promises in 2010 that got in bed with the Conservatives? And yeah, they failed. They didn't keep their promises there, did they? Oh yeah, isn't this the same ones that had a part? This is also the same Liberal Democrats that they had their leader Jo Swinson in 2019 said that she was going to become Prime Minister, and she ended up losing her seat in doing so as well. Yeah, that's the same Liberal Democrat Party we're talking about. We haven't forgotten them, have we? But in terms of obviously coverage, this is good. This is good publicity for Liberal Democrats. There is a saying that any publicity is good publicity. The resulting footage and pictures have garnered significant media attention for the party, which had 15 MPs when Parliament was dissolved, and it's polling in third place on about 9%. Davey hopes to pull off a similar feat to the 1997, when the Liberal Democrats under Paddy Ashdown increased their numbers of seats from 18 to 46. That is quite an ambition if they were to get that many seats. I think it would be very good if they were to get roughly around 40 to 50 seats. I think it'd be a great achievement for them. I definitely think it's realistic. But it's just convincing those who some Conservative voters who are going to vote for Reform, convincing them to vote for the Liberal Democrats in those blue wall seats. That's going to be a challenge for them. But obviously saying things, obviously, like they're going to do, things they're going to do about the healthcare, things they're going to do about the environment, and obviously about free school meals. These are very appealing things to certain particular kinds of voters. So these are some very good, they are some very good things that the Liberal Democrats are saying. David would not commit to a number of target number six, but said, "It looks like a once-in-a-generation election, a bit like 1997. This is the moment for progressives to seize. He said that behind the stunts was a party with serious and bold proposals in policy areas such as education, health and social care. The Lib Dems are pinching themselves as an alternative to Labour for progressives who want to get the Tories out. Asked once again whether he would rule out going into a coalition with the Conservatives in July, David said 100%. But he would not rule out a coalition with Keir Starmer's Labour. Yeah, they can't. Yeah. After what happened last time, they really shot themselves in the foot with that. I'm not talking about anything beyond what I've just said on the Tories, for the simple reason that I want to campaign on Liberal Democrat policies. I think it's right that we've made it very clear that the Conservatives are anathema to us. I fought Tories all my life. I fight them every day. On which high-profile Conservatives, he would love to see his party defeated. Like to see the Conservative Party defeated, basically. Davey named three: the Chancellor Jeremy Hunt, the Education Secretary Gillian Keegan, and the Justice Secretary Alex Chalk. The one I want to see the Lib Dems oust is Jeremy Hunt. I would love to. They are targeting his seat, and he is very nervous about it. I definitely hope that the Liberal Democrats do oust him on his seat. It would be so sweet if it do. Davey refused to set his conditions on propping up for a Labour government in the event of a hung parliament. whether in a coalition or looser confidence and supply arrangement. Though he said electoral reform has always been a Lib Dem high priority, he said he has not spoken privately to Starmer since before the campaign began. I sat next to him during the King's coronation. He said we compared notes and we talked about football as well. As you know, he's an Arsenal fan. I'm a Notts County fan. I think he's probably knows more about football than I do. But let me be very, very honest. I've always followed football when he plays it. Some questions. What difference is Davey from Starmer? When asked this, he said he finds it easier to detail things they have in common. There are things in his life which he's had to struggle with that I've had quite a few in mine. There are actually more similarities in terms of our upbringing. We've had challenges to face, he said. Davey has been a carer for most of his life, first for his mother who became terminally ill when he was a child, and then for his grandmother, and now for his son John, who is disabled. He feels an affiliate with Starmer, who has spoken about his mother's struggle with Steele's disease. When the general election was called, Davey and his daughter Ellie had been due to join the rest of the family in Budapest, where John regularly visits a specialist institution for neurology conditions. Instead, Davey's brother stepped in to take Ellie to Hungary so Davey could start campaigning. The family returned home this weekend after 2 weeks later. He said, I'm very excited. It's the longest time I've been away from my wife since we got married and my son since we were born, Davey said. Besides a couple of constituency commitments, he will be taking a break from the campaign trail for a family weekend. So he is going to take a little break. Ed Davey, just to spend some time with the family there. But again, this is another policy from the Liberal Democrats that I really definitely I like. If it can obviously raise funds as well with what this US spy share buyback tax sounds good. And like I said right at the start, guys, we want to give kids the best possible chance in the future. And what better way to do that than providing them with all the meals they say? Now, a counter argument that some people may make in the comments section is that there are some people who are pretty well off and they're just going to be getting an extra meal out of it. And my response is, well, what's wrong with that? I don't see it as a problem. I don't see it as a problem. It's one of the counter arguments. I know there's going to be other counter arguments in the comments below, but I don't think this should be a debate. There should not be a discussion about whether we should be giving free school meals to kids or not. This should be a given, because if we care about the future, the next generation, we want to ensure that they are given every single best opportunity they possibly can, and not providing them with a full meal. I mean, come on. Let's just get real here. It's a gimme. It really, really is on this one. But what do you guys think? What do you guys make of the Lib Dems' policy to extend free school meals to all primary school children? What do you guys make of him having discussions with Keir Starmer about the possibility that they could gain coalition at the general election? It's unlikely, given the polling numbers at the moment. But what do you guys honestly think about that? About the fact that he's challenged Labour for the £500 million pledge as well. Let me know your thoughts and more in the comments section down below. If you found this video interesting, please hit the like button. We greatly appreciate it. Share it across social media so others are notified of this video. And subscribe, because it really does help support the channel. And if you want to go one step further, financially support me and the work that I do here, you can do so by becoming a YouTube member for as little as 99p, or join me on Rumble or Patreon for exclusive content on those platforms. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope to catch you all very, very soon.